Hello and welcome to this next video on mobile repairing. In this video, we will try and understand how to rectify a fault in one of the most important components of a mobile phone. The component that we will be working on today is called the display. The display is essentially a component which is an output device and shows you what is being worked on. It displays the incoming call details, it displays the outgoing mobile numbers. If you have a multimedia mobile phone, it will show you audio, video files, photographs, etc. Many a times the display can have faults in them or can develop faults in them, and it's important to identify the defects and learn how to replace the display component of a mobile phone. Now, what you see in front of you is the display component of this mobile phone. Now, it's very clearly seen here, the black color screen is the display component of this mobile phone. This is where all the interactions with your phone are shown to you very clearly, be it video files, audio files, mobile phone numbers or calls that you are making, or even SMSs or messages that you get on your mobile phone. Now, if the display has a problem, you will be able to identify it very clearly. Many a times the display is cracked because the phone was dropped down. In such a case, you can very clearly see the crack on the mobile phone screen. Many a times you may also be able to see some kind of a liquid formed on the screen. In these situations, you will have to replace the entire display. For replacing, you will need to use the SMD. We have already known about this device. There are adjustments for air and heater. So you try and turn the heater to the respective heat position and turn on the air knob so that the airflow starts off. This device, as we understood earlier, is also called as hot air gun because it blows out hot air through its nozzle. So the first device that we will be using now is the hot air gun. The display can be removed from the PCB using the hot air gun. So the point where the display is soldered on to the PCB has the soldering iron in it. So you place the hot air gun on top of it and blow hot air onto it, and this melts the solder that connects the display with the PCB. You can hold a tweezer to try and slowly handle the display device and pull it out of the PCB. As you can see, it because we use the hot air gun, it has melted the solder, and we've been able to easily remove the display component of this mobile device. And underneath on the PCB, you can see the display tip here. So the display tip is where the display device is soldered onto the PCB. The tips are very important. The tips need to be clean so that there is communication, easy communication or unhindered communication between the PCB and the display unit. Now, in order to solder a new display unit, first is take some soldering wire, melt a little bit of soldering wire onto the soldering tip and try and wipe this once, and then place the display unit on top of it and re-solder it again. Now, you may need to understand that the display unit of each of these mobile devices could be very different, and they connect to the mobile phone PCB in very different ways. In this mobile, we need to solder the display unit onto the PCB. Many units normally have a lock system in them which does not require any soldering. In those cases, all you need to do is unlock the display device and you will be able to take it out. And to place it back inside, you can lock it back using the locks provided there or the locking system provided on the PCB. Depending on the mobile device, you need to purchase the respective display unit for that particular mobile device. These are very different types of mobile devices. Each one will require a different type of mobile display component. Please identify the right mobile device and replace it with the correct display component for that respective mobile. Now, this soldering part or the desoldering or removing part and the replacement of display device is a very complex work and cannot be done very easily. So, it's recommended that you practice with a lot of old non-working mobile phones before you actually work on any customer's mobile phone to avoid any damage to the customer's mobile. In order to solder it back, align the tips on the device, on the display component, with the display tips provided on the PCB. And then use a soldering iron to solder them onto its respective positions. So we melt a little bit of soldering lead and try and wipe it on the display device as well as the tips. And this connects the display unit along with the PCB. As you can see, we take a little bit of soldering iron and we are trying to connect these two components. Please ensure that the components are aligned at the right position to ensure that the connectivity is intact between the PCB and the display unit. As you can see, we've tried soldering it and it's perfectly aligned. You need to ensure that the solders don't overlap. If the solders of two tips or two different points overlap, that could result in shorting and may spoil the display unit or may not allow the display unit to function properly. So each of those individual tips and connecting points should be unique, and there should be no overlap of soldering between two subsequent or consecutive mobile tips or the display tips there. You can try and redo it once again to ensure that all the points are adequately connected to the PCB. While doing this, please ensure that you hold the display device properly so that the display device is not damaged. Handle it carefully because the display device could crack if you leave it as such, or if the display device falls down. So hold it properly until you are really sure that the display device is properly soldered on into the mobile phone. Just for your comfort, let us try and redo this whole process once again, so you are really sure about how we need to do this exactly. As we said earlier, this requires multiple practices before we can do it. We are taking the hot air gun and we are blowing the hot air gun or the SMD nozzle straight on to the display unit where it's soldered, and you can see very clearly the soldering is giving way, and holding a tweezer, you will be able to take the display unit out of the PCB. So you, as the heat increases, the solder melts and you are able to take the display unit out of the mobile PCB. Once the display unit is removed, we melt a little bit of soldering lead onto your soldering iron and wipe it off on the tips, the display tips on the PCB. Place the display device on top and slowly solder it. Now, while you are doing this, please ensure that you are keeping the mobile phone PCB on a PCB stand, because something like this will require a very stable PCB stand. Otherwise, if you do it in hand, it can cause harm to your hand as well as to the mobile PCB as well. Also, ensure that you place the PCB in a convenient position where it's easy for you to solder it correctly, because the alignment is very, very critical. If there is a mismatch in the alignment, or if there is an overlap of alignment, it could result in short circuit of the display unit. So align them properly in the right position. Take the soldering iron, melt a little bit lead, and try and connect these two points onto the mobile PCB. Now remember, this is very, very, very critical. And you need to ensure that you are 100% sure about what you need to do. So practice a lot using non-working mobile phone devices before you work on any of the customer's mobile phones. As you can see here, it's a very simple process but requires extreme care, caution, and a lot of practice before you can do it comfortably without any issues. So we are resoldering it just to ensure that all the leads are aligned properly to the tips on the mobile phone PCB. Once they are soldered on, you can very clearly see that the display device is intact, and you can now reassemble the phone and test whether the display unit is working properly or not. We do hope you would have learned about how to replace a display unit of a mobile phone using this video. Once again, please ensure that you are keeping all safety precautions in mind while you are working on this particular aspect of mobile phone repairing. Continue learning. Good luck. Thank you very much.